After suffering a devastating ACL tear and missing 539 days, resulting into a slow start in the new season, Jamal Murray has recently started to pick up the pace. But if anything, it's really been the past 20 games where he's taking an insane jump as a player. And in the past 20 games, Jamal Murray has been averaging 23.7 points per game, 6.3 assists, and 4.7 rebounds on 49, 45, and basically 90% from the free throw line. And no, I'm not coming up with these numbers. And if you want to move the sample size to 15 games, he's been averaging 24.6 points per game on 62.8% true shooting. That's nuts. Not only is this like Jamal Murray's career year, but two, this is like his best stretch in his career, excluding the bubble, of course. But from like a basketball standpoint, Jamal Murray is taking like an incredible leap as a player. Not only is his pull-up shooting like incredible and it's completely unlocked the offense, but his pick and roll stuff has also unlocked the offense. And this season, Jamal's been an aggressive shot taker. Right here is the perfect example. He is going to get a screen from Jokic onto Reggie Jackson, and he creates enough airspace for Blue Arrow to go ahead and get up his shot. And these pick and rolls and pull-up threats are going to unlock the offense for sure. Here is another possession where Alexei Pokuševski is not watching Aaron Gordon come for the screen. So Aaron Gordon is going to go ahead and set the back screen. And Jamal is going to come off this back screen. And again, it's just enough space to go ahead and get up this shot. This is partially due to Pokuševski missing the rotation. So now Kimmich has to go ahead and try to contest the shot. And it's still just enough space for Jamal to go ahead and make the shot. Jamal's more aggressive shot approach has opened up his acumen for getting into spots and flying around on the perimeter, being able to be a threat from the outside, but also put pressure on defenses to guard Jokic. Jamal Murray's new profound elite pull-up shooting, but also Jokic's offensive prowess, is a precariousness around the league. This looks like a great value chin action that the Nuggets run. Jamal's going to go for the down screen after the cut, and he's going to come up, but Aaron Gordon is going to cut himself, and this is basically just a dribble handoff that Jamal is going to get from Jokic, and it just creates so much space and just airspace for Jamal to go ahead and just settle into a shot. Which is basically why I said, what Jamal does is going to be a threat from Jokic because the defense is going to attract attention from Jokic. Jamal Murray's pull-up shooting renaissance is certifiable. In the past 15 games, he's averaging 12.5 pull-up points, and he's also shooting 50% of pull-ups. So that would be the last 15 games in the league. He's missed 7 of those games, but even then, in those 8 games, he's been crazy. And also in those 8 games, he's been averaging 28 points per game. And no, it's not a one-of-one comparison, but it's kind of how the Nuggets use Jamal, similar to Steph. Steph is going to come off this flare action. And using the space that Draymond created with his mask, Steph is going to come off of it and get open space to go ahead and create a shot. It's the same thing here. Steph is going to like play casually on the perimeter, and then Lamb's going to set this mirror ball screen, and Steph gets just a little bit of space to go ahead and get a shot off. You do not want Jamal Murray probing like this, or even flowing like this, and his two-man game with Jokic this season has been better than it was before. And this two-man synergy could overwhelm defenses. With Murray's shooting threat, he stresses the defense and can leave a wide-open Jokic for the mid-range, and that's a shot you don't want him taking. This stressing that Jamal puts on defenses is pretty overwhelming again, and Jokic is shooting 59% from 8 to 16 feet. It's pretty impressive. This passing and shooting symbiosis can really strain defenses, as Jamal's going to go ahead and stress Aiden and free up a Jokic that is guarded by a smaller Mikal Bridges, and of course Jokic is going to go ahead and just float the shot over him. Nikola Jokic is having an historic shooting season himself. He's averaging 25 points per game on 70% true shooting, and from 16 to 24 feet, he's shooting 62%. He's really, really efficient this year, and Jamal's playmaking jump has honestly helped this in a sense. And then you have Jamal Murray's nuclear shooting. He's shooting about 40% from 3 on 6 attempts per game, and he's really been knocking down his shots this season. He's been shooting 38.6% above the break, and he's been shooting 50% in both corners. Albeit, his corner stuff is very limited, and it's a small sample size, but if you see the shots that he's taking, they're really difficult shots, and his shot making this season has been really impressive. And Jamal Murray is one of the best tough shot makers in the league. If I say he was a top 10 tough shot maker, you'd probably think I would be trolling, but he really is. Blue Arrow gets Devontae Graham in this threat, and then he hits him with the right to left cross, and then gets into the step back and creates a little bit of space, but it's enough space to go ahead and get the shot off. This threat as a shooter, but also a ball handler, stresses defenses to the max. And again, a little bit of space is enough for Jamal to get shots off. Jamal Murray also has one of the better handles in the league. Being able to put the ball on the screen, but also get into open spaces and navigate mismatches is something that is really underrated of his. Although Jamal does have a bigger on-ball role, he could do some stuff off the ball as well. And again, this shot making can really help out the Nuggets. Post-injury, Jamal has lost a little bit of that explosion that he had, but he still has enough explosion to still get into open spaces, but also create space and hit tough shots off the space that he does create. Like right here, Jamal comes off this back screen from Christian Brown, but Hyland gets a solid screen, and Zeke Nnaji gets the final kill on Josh Okogie and knock him to the ground, and it's enough space they all created for Jamal to get off this tough fadeaway shot in the corner. And then to complete some of his stuff on offense, Jamal Murray has been a really nice finisher this year. Jamal is a really crafty finisher, and he has a deep bag of layups and all that kind of stuff that can really trick defenses. But the big problem with me and Jamal is that he doesn't put enough pressure on the rim at times, he avoids contact sometimes, and he doesn't get to the line enough. Jamal Murray's in the 50th percentile on free throw rate, being 23.4%. If he got to the line more, he's probably averaging like 27 or even 28 points per game. And I really do mean that, but he avoids contact, and that's the problem. Other than that, yeah, Jamal Murray's having a good year, and at the start of the season, probably all the way to like game 20, I wasn't really high on him. He wasn't really playing that well, the shot wasn't falling, he looked like he lost burst, and his defense was atrocious, but sometimes you have to thug it out, and it's going to be muddy, it's going to be hard, and sometimes you just got to stick through, and that was hard, but Jamal proved me wrong, and he's been playing really good. Is he an all-star snub? I don't know, y'all let me know down below. If you do enjoy this video and you do like the content, you can go ahead and subscribe. Not asking for it, but a like and a subscription would be appreciated. It shows that you are interested in these videos. So, yeah, I appreciate y'all, and I'm out. It's always one step forward and